Hey there, it's Irene Lyon. Welcome to this video, to this YouTube channel, and to this world of healing trauma, nervous system health, and all things neuroplasticity. I wanted to teach you a piece of education today, a concept that is from the world of somatic experiencing. That is the work that I have been trained in. One of the things I'm trained in, it's the work of Dr. Peter Levine. And the term is pendulation. I'm gonna say that one more time, pendulation. Peter took the concept, well, it's an actual thing, one of those pendulums that go back and forth, good old-fashioned pendulums, and this idea of pendulating, moving our focus, our attention from one thing to something else, and then going back and forth between two things. And so I'm going to give you a few examples and show you what this means in the realms of healing trauma and nervous system health and well-being, and just being able to navigate overwhelming sensations, painful qualities that we might experience in our body, but also being overstimulated by the environment. And it goes without saying that many of us and many people within the world at any given day are being overwhelmed or being bombarded by information, but also sensations, emotions, and qualities of their somatic experience that they don't know what to do with. So one of the things to understand about pendulation is that it's about moving and refocusing attention. I'm going to say that one more time. Moving and refocusing attention on somewhere that is less bad, on somewhere that is less scary, that is less triggering, that is less stressful, that is less intense. So this idea of shifting focus, shifting attention, so it takes our cognitive ability and skill to track and find something to shift our focus, so that when we shift focus to this other thing that is less intense, we take the heat off in a way, the thing that is intense. I'm going to give you an example. I'm going to use the example of, say, something painful in the body. So for the sake of example, we'll talk about, say, a pain in, say, a shoulder. So let's say someone has, maybe it's an old injury, maybe it's a body sensation that's coming up and out due to an old traumatic event, and the area is getting achy. Maybe it's a burning, maybe it's a discomfort, maybe it's a tightness. So pick the descriptor that you want to use, but something doesn't feel good in the shoulder. And sometimes when we have pain in our body, overwhelming sensations, etc., these pains, these qualities of sensation can overtake us. It's like they hijack us and we can't sense anything else but that shoulder pain. What we want to do, or what we do, I should say, in this practice of pendulation is we ask the person, might be my client, it might be one of my students, or you, focusing on something that has a little bit of sting, a little bit of heat to it, is to refocus attention and find somewhere else in the body or somewhere else outside of the body to focus on. So for example, you might notice that your feet are on the floor. You might notice that your hands actually feel pretty okay. You might notice that there's a glass of water, which I do have, right in front of you. You might notice my sky outside is blue today, so there's this brilliant blue sky. There's a plane that I can see flying across. And so moving attention, pendulating from that ouchy, sore, painful shoulder to something else. So let's just say, for example, I'm noticing this and I say, you know what, I'm gonna notice this glass of water. I'm just gonna feel it. I'm gonna feel the glass. I'm gonna see the fluidness of the water. Might move the water around. Of course, I would do this not necessarily while talking. I'm just talking you through this, but it's to shift the focus, to pendulate and just be like, huh, this is what I notice. And when I notice this glass of water, what I notice is I'm actually feeling a little more grounded with what I'm sitting on. As I notice this water, and again, these are just examples, I actually notice my breath comes back, for example. Or we might say something like, we might realize, again, the sky outside. As I focus and reorient to the external world, what I'm noticing is Oh, there's a settling in my system. My eyes get a little more less tense. My throat softens. My belly relaxes. And so we're shifting focus to something that is more pleasant, that is less intense, less scary, less bad, more safe, let's say, could be more safe. And then once we focus on that and we check in with our internal system, we then move our focus, we pendulate back to the shoulder. Now, depending on the severity, depending on the intensity, it might be that there's still a pain there, but it may have shifted. It may have shifted to, maybe it was a throbbing ache and now it's just this dull ache. And maybe that ache has spread a little bit and it feels like the arm is a little numb, but the intensity is gone here. So we would then notice that. We would focus on that, notice our breath. When we feel this kind of dull ache, we register in our brain that there has been a state shift in how we notice our sensation. And then we would say, okay, what would it be like to move your focus back out to the sky, or move the focus back to that glass of water? Or what would it be like to move the focus to that breath that you're feeling that's a little bigger, that has a little more flow and capacity? So that's one example of how you would take an area that is a little hot, a little tender, a little intense, and shift the focus, pendulate the focus to something else. Again, it doesn't have to be something in the body, because I understand for, let's say, folks who are living with chronic pain, maybe chronic fatigue, etc., it might be that it's really hard to find something in the body that feels less painful, that feels less bad, that feels good. And so it's okay to bring the focus outside into the environment, or the interface between you and the environment, like the feet. This is why asking people to feel their feet to ground, this is a practice that's been around for a long, long time. And it's because it's not distracting our attention. It's not asking us to disconnect from our body. It's asking us to refocus our focus somewhere else, so that we're not just looking and feeling and sensing this big ball of badness, essentially. So we're trying to find things that are less bad, so that we shift the survival stress within the physiology. One more example I'll give you. A lot of people will find that when they go outside into the environment, especially in big cities where there's a lot of population, a lot of lights and intensity and sounds, that there'll be this overwhelming sense. And it's just so much that we'll find people will actually stop going out into the world because it's just too intense. Now, what we need to do, because we want people to be able to go into the world, get the things they need to get, visit the people they need to visit, do the things of daily life. We don't want to stop doing that, because once we stop doing that, we lose our independence, we lose our freedom. So when we go outside, for example, and let's just say we know that we are someone that gets over flooded with all of the stimulus outside, how can that quality of feeling, or how can a person notice this? How might you notice this? And then actively, consciously pendulate, move your focus to something less big, less intense. Again, it doesn't have to be something in the body, but it could be. It could be, I'm just gonna feel my feet, or I'm just gonna feel my hands in my pockets, or I'm just gonna feel my arms a little bit as I walk outside and just stay connected and grounded. It might be that rather than looking at all of the pieces and having it flooding in, you make a deliberate effort to notice the sky, as I just mentioned. Maybe there's clouds. Maybe there are birds. Maybe there's a shine of the window in buildings. Maybe you read the signs that you see. Maybe you take a very slow, methodical gaze at what you're seeing, and you have to actively slow it down so that the information coming in slows down as well. So again, to rewind this idea of pendulating, we need to come back then to our body. So let's just say again, for example, you walk outside, you're overstimulated, you start to feel, maybe, again, this is a hypothetical example, you feel your heart rate start to go up, you start to feel everything really tighten and contract. So focus the attention somewhere else, refocus, pendulate, but then you're going to want to pendulate and swing back to the body. Notice, what is it doing now? Does it have the same intensity in the heart rate? Is there the same squeezing, or has there been a shift? Doesn't mean that all the qualities that you feel are going to be gone, going to be completely bleached away, but it's to notice the nuance and the subtlety of something that may have shifted. And what we want to focus on are the shifts. It's not about having no experience, no somatic experience, no sensation, no emotions, but knowing that we can shift and change them. And then, as I mentioned before with the other example, then bringing the focus back to the external to notice, what am I noticing now? Has something died down? Is the information coming in a little less fast? So this process of moving our focus out and back into the internal, it's slow. This isn't something that's happening quick, quick, quick like that. It's long, slow, deliberate refocusing. And then once we take in that environment, notice what we might notice. Maybe it's our feet. Maybe it's our hands. Maybe we notice our breath as opposed to all the chaos. And then we feel that, we notice that, and then we bring our focus back out to the external. So it's a very fluid, a very flowy way of shifting your focus, shifting your attention, pendulating and noticing. Maybe it's the somatic experience inside. It could even be thoughts that we're noticing, and we're getting wrapped up in our thoughts, you know, into those spirals of thoughts that we sometimes get into. And to be like, okay, I'm in this thought cycle. This is not getting me anywhere. I'm going to refocus, and I'm going to pendulate my focus and attention to my hands or to that glass of water. I'm going to look at the water. I might even talk to the water. I might thank the water for hydrating me and giving me fluid into my body. I might look outside. And in the process of being active with our brain and conscious to choose and find different things, things usually settle. There's a reason why when kids are on long car rides, usually games like finding things on the external, you know, find something that's red, find something that's green. There's so many old games that I remember and my husband talks about. They're a way to help shift focus and attention and really reground, in that case, kids in the car that might be going at it, fighting, being really rambunctious, and you got this long car ride ahead of you. And it's a way of reorienting and refocusing. So in some ways, we naturally do this as humans. And if we know that we have trouble self-regulating, trouble finding settling, if we are living with a lot of pain, a lot of intensity, a lot of loopy thoughts that just keep going and going nowhere, I wanted to teach you this and give you an idea of how you can shift that focus, how you can pendulate to a different area, a different thing, a different quality, a different place around you so that you can really rest this intensity that might be kind of overwhelming and overtaking you. I'm going to also mention two other videos that I want you to check out. One is The Power of Orienting. It's, again, on this YouTube channel. I'll link them below. This ability to orient and really see our environment. It's a skill that we want to build up and learn. This will help us with this concept of pendulation. And the other is the ability to really understand what regulation is and the importance of being able to settle our system and not keep putting our system into more stress response, more stress response. We want to really learn how to bring our physiology down so that we don't keep scaring and hurting ourselves, not only from the physical level, mental level, emotional level, but in how we relate to that which is around us. All right, so a few pieces of homework there. Again, like I said, I'll post them at the bottom in the show more section so you can watch those. Thank you so much for being here, and start practicing this skill of pendulation. Thank you so much for being here, and we will see you next time.